Today, we're in Baltimore, Maryland, and this is the Maryland Science Center. It's home to the Hubble Space Telescope's National Visitor Center, and it's a lot of fun. It has three floors of hands-on experiments to get students like you interested in astronomy. Let's go on in and check it out. Excuse me, Seth.
Today's show is called Algebra, Mirror, Mirror on the Universe. And this mirror right here, it's the same size as the primary mirror on the Hubble Space Telescope. But more on the Hubble later.
First, let's learn about algebra.
Algebra? What's algebra? Sounds scary.
It's really not. Let me show you. Can you read this graph? I bet you didn't know that when you're reading graphs, you're doing algebra. Algebra is used to describe a relationship between two or more things. For example, in this graph, we can say that the number of pizzas is related to the number of people served. The more pizzas you have, the more people you can serve. That's a relationship. In fact, this graph shows a linear relationship. A linear relationship means that the points on the graph appear to form a straight line. Of course, there are lots of relationships in math, but since these examples don't form a straight line, they aren't linear. Got it? So, looking at this graph, how many people would one pizza serve? Let's set up a table to show the relationship we see in the graph. Let's label our table like this. N equals the number of pizzas, and P equals the number of people served. According to our graph, one pizza serves two people. That means there are two servings in one pizza. For our purposes, this number of servings, two, doesn't change. It's called a constant. How many people would be served if you have two pizzas? What about three pizzas? You should begin to see a pattern developing. Now, what if you were planning a sleepover and your mom got carried away and ordered 215 pizzas? How many people would you have to invite to your slumber party? Remember the pattern we saw in the graph and table? Let's use the pattern we saw in the table to set up the relationship. In algebra, letters called variables help us solve algebraic equations. Remember how we used the letters N and P in the table to represent the number of pizzas and the number of people being served? Using those variables, we can set up an equation like this. N, which is the number of pizzas, times the number of servings in one pizza equals P, which is the number of people served. Okay, what do we know? Well, remembering that there are two servings in one pizza and that your mom ordered 215 pizzas, we can substitute those numbers like this. 215 times 2 equals P. According to our graph, you will have to invite 430 people over for your slumber party. Better tell your mom to cool it. So you see, guys, algebra isn't scary at all. In fact, algebra is used to solve problems much tougher than the one we just did.
And remember, there are lots of ways to do problems algebraically.
Absolutely. Now that we've gotten a taste of algebra, let's learn more about telescopes. 1608 was a happening year. In that year, the Italian scientist Galileo became one of the first humans to view celestial objects with the newly invented telescope. Galileo improved on the design to see objects 10 times more clearly than ever before possible. With his primitive telescope, Galileo saw many thousands of previously invisible stars that make up part of our galaxy. The ancient Greeks named our galaxy the Milky Way, because most of its visible stars appear overhead on a clear dark night as a milky band of light extending across the sky. How many galaxies do you think are in the universe?
Maybe a couple trillion.
Well, I know there's at least one.
340 billion.
Those are all good guesses. To get the real answer, stay tuned because later on in the show, you'll have the opportunity to estimate the number of galaxies in the universe with our web activity.
During the centuries following Galileo's discoveries, scientists created telescopes of increasing size and complexity. For more information on telescopes and something called optics, let's visit Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama.